Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Today, this is our third lecture, and today we will discuss vitamin B12 and folate deficiencies. This is basically megaloblastic anemia. Megaloblastic anemia, this is basically is a group of disorder which is described by distinctive morphological appearance of developing erythroid cells in the bone marrow and due to deficiency of vitamin B12 or folate. In megaloblastic anemia, patient can present with isolated anemia or maybe with pancytopenia. In this diagram, we can see the patient have HP only 8.7 gram per deciliter, which is below normal. WBC count is also decreased and platelet count is also decreased. So, patient with megaloblastic anemia can present with isolated anemia or with pancytopenia. The MCP of the patient will be above normal range. These are the few most common causes of the macrocytic anemia. The most common is the vitamin B12 and folate deficiency anemia. The rest is the alcoholism, liver disease, newborn, pregnancy, multiple myeloma, reticulocytosis. These all can cause RBCs, macrocytosis in the peripheral blood film. In megaloblastic anemia, when there is deficiency of either vitamin B12 and folic acid, it leads to impairment of the DNA synthesis. As the result of ineffective hematopoiesis leads to large erythroid precursors and red cells in the bone marrow. Now, causes of vitamin B12 deficiency. First of all, when there is in decreased intake, basically those patients who have inadequate diet or purely vegetarians, there is specific tendency of vitamin B12 deficiency. Other causes include intrinsic factor deficiency. The main cause of intrinsic factor deficiency is pernicious anemia and gastrectomy. Then malabsorption states, different surgeries, different intestinal disorders. This all leads to decrease in vitamin B12 deficiency. This all leads to vitamin B12 deficiency. The main causes of folic acid deficiency is decrease in diet, decrease intake, and its increased requirement. Number 3 is malabsorption. Its increased use most commonly occur during pregnancy, infancy, and hemolytic disorders. Impaired absorption occur in patients with malabsorption disorders, with intestinal diseases, and with certain drugs, anticonvulsants, or oral contraceptives. Certain drugs like methotrexate is the metabolic inhibitor of DNA. It also leads to megaloblastic anemia. Rich source of vitamin B12 is the meat and fish, while the rich source of folic acid is the green leafy vegetables. the maximum absorption of vitamin B12 occur in the ileum, which is the proximal segment of the small intestine. The vitamin B12 is absorbed maximally in the ileum, which is the terminal portion of the small intestine. And the folic acid absorbed in the duodenum, this is the proximal segment of the small intestine. Now, basically, vitamin B12 and folic acids are the coenzyme for the synthesis of DNA. This basically required for the synthesis of thymidine, which is one of the four bases found in the DNA. Deficiency of these enzymes leads to impairment in the metabolism, and there is defect in nuclear maturation. It leads to inadequate DNA synthesis, and there may be delay or block in the cell division. Vitamin B12 totally depends on dietary animal products, which is the meat and fish, etc. Daily requirement is 2 to 3 milligrams. Most important, first of all, for the absorption of vitamin B12, we require intrinsic factor, which is secreted from the parietal cells of the fundal mucosa. Now the steps. First of all, vitamin B12 from the food is separated by the salivary enzymes, and then they bind to different salivary protein, for example R binder. In the duodenum, these R binder vitamin B12 is complex is broken down by the pancreatic proteases. The vitamin B12 which release in the duodenum become associated with the intrinsic factor. In this diagram, we can see the vitamin B12 in the food is broken down by the salivary enzymes, and here it binds with the R binder. In the stomach, there will be release of intrinsic factor, and vitamin B12, which is initially associated with R binder, is broken down from here. And it will attach with intrinsic factor. Now, this vitamin B12 and intrinsic factor complex is endocytosis by the specific receptors on the surface of ileum. Inside the ileum, vitamin B12 is dissociated from the intrinsic factor and attacks with transcobalamin 2. And it delivers to liver and other cells of the body. For example, rapidly proliferating cells, bone marrow. In this diagram, we can see after absorption from the ileum, the vitamin B12 is attached with the transcobalamin 2. Now, biochemical function of vitamin B12. Vitamin B12 acts in these two main biochemical reactions. It acts as a coenzyme. Number one is methylation of the homocysteine to methionine, and number two, it is help in conversion of methyl mineral coenzyme A to succinyl CoA. These are the two reactions. First of all, homocysteine is converted into methionine with the help of in the presence of coenzyme vitamin B12. In this process, methyl, in the presence of methyl tetra 5-methyl tetrahydrofolate. And there is transfer of the methyl group, and the 5-methyl tetrahydrofolate will convert it into tetrahydrofolate, and after that this further leads to DNA synthesis. This adenosyl S-adenosyl methionine basically help in methylated product, which is the basically used inside the CNS for the methylation of the neurons like myelin sheaths. Now folate, dietary folate, basically these are the methyl tetrahydrofolate. What happened before going inside the cell, the methyl tetrahydrofolate has to be converted into tetrahydrofolate. For that, after that, it leads to formation of folate polyglutamates, and then they are used in the as a precursor for DNA synthesis. See, this is the form 5-methyl tetrahydrofolate, which is the form of the folic acid inside the plasma, and before going inside the cell it is converted into tetrahydrofolate, which then further leads to help in DNA synthesis. In this diagram, what we can see, there is 5-methyl tetrahydrofolate which is in the monoglutamate form, which is present inside the plasma. When it enters inside the cell, it leads to formation of the tetrahydrofolate. This is the first reaction which occurs inside the cell by which is the synthesis of the methionine. And this 5-methyl tetrahydrofolate heat water acts as the methyl donor. After that, it forms tetrahydrofolate. Tetrahydrofolate then converted into 5-10-methylene tetrahydrofolate. This enzyme is basically used for the conversion of deoxyuridine monophosphate to deoxythymidine monophosphate. This is a basic reaction which helped by the enzymes to the DNA synthesis. At this point, basically this is a defect which leads to decrease in vitamin B12 and folic acid deficiency due to disturbances in the DNA cycle. After that, this is the normal reaction. What does this 5-10-methylene tetrahydrofolate do? What is it? It converts deoxyuridine monophosphate to deoxythymidine monophosphate. After that, it leads to formation of 4 nitrogenous bases and leads to DNA formation. Now, there is basically problem in these steps. And normally, then it will convert it into dihydrofolate. With the help of enzyme, dihydrofolate reductase, it again converted into tetrahydrofolate. Now this cycle can continue. Now diagnosis. First of all, we have to diagnose megaloblastic anemia, then type of deficiency and cause of deficiency. First of all, clinical features related to anemia. Patient will have fatigue, pallor, easy fatigability, thrombocytopenia. Patient has the history of bruises, bleeding, and leukopenia, history of infections. Other symptoms. This include neurological manifestations of the vitamin B12 deficiency. What happens? It leads to loss of position sense and ataxia. There will be decrease in deep tendon reflexes, muscle weakness, loss of vibration sense. This all due to subacute combined degeneration of the spinal cord due to vitamin B12 deficiency and peripheral neuropathy. There is mental changes, for example, memory loss, confusion, hallucinations and dementia. Patient complain of loss of appetite, plus glossitis, diarrhea and constipation. Rest include vitiligo. These are the rare. Hyperpigmentation, premature graying of the hairs, weight loss and splenomegaly. Lab investigations. On the peripheral blood feature film, there will be anemia and patients have raised MCV. It is most commonly more than 100 femtoliter. Thrombocytopenia, decreased WBC count, decreased platelet count and decreased reticulin count. On peripheral blood feature, patients have macrocytes, oval macrocytes. There is hypersegmented neutrophils. Normally, neutrophils have 3 to 4 labs. But what happened in megaloblastic anemia, more than 5 neutrophils have 5 or more labs. Other test, screening test, we can have bilirubin levels of LDH. We have previously discussed this feature. There will be anemia. HP will be decreased. WMCV of the patient will be high. In decrease in WBC and platelet count. This is the peripheral blood feature. These are the RBCs, which is the macrocytes or macroevaluocytes. And this neutrophil has the hypersegmented neutrophils. It has almost 8 to 9 lobes. Now in the bone marrow will be hypercellular and there will be hyperplastic erythropoiesis most likely. And RBCs will be erythroid precursors will be enlarged, which is the megaloblastic. Myeloboses mein there will be giant metamyelocytes and giant myelocytes. See, these are the abnormally large megaloblastic erythroids. Vitamin B12 levels we can do and vitamin and serum folate levels. One of the most common cause of pernicious anemia, vitamin B12 deficiency is the pernicious anemia, for which we can also Schilling test, homocysteine levels, and rest of the investigations include serum red cell folate levels, stool culture, basically. Pernicious anemia is an autoimmune condition which impairs the production of intrinsic factor which required for vitamin B12 intake. In pernicious anemia, there will be autoimmune attack on the gastric mucosa which leads to atrophic gastritis, loss of all the parietal cells which help in secretion of intrinsic factor. There are basically three types of autoantibodies. First is block the binding of vitamin B12 to intrinsic factor. Number two, prevent binding of intrinsic factor vitamin B12 complex to allele receptor. Number three, which is the basically it act on the gastric proton pump cells and affect gastric parietal cells. Basically what happened that after the autoimmune attack on the gastric mucosa, it leads to atrophy of the gastric mucosa affecting both cells of the gastric epithelium, which is the chief cells and parietal cells, and these normal epithelium is replaced by mucus secreting goblet cells, It is the form of metaplasia which is known as intestinalization. After that, there will be known secretion of intrinsic factor, and that and vitamin B12 cannot be absorbed across the ileum. So this is basically how we will diagnose vitamin B12 or folic deficiency, which is the leads to megaloblastic anemia. We will do CP, complete blood picture, peripheral blood picture, reticulocyte count, patient's bone marrow in selective cases, and rest is we will do serum folate levels, vitamin B12 levels, and in some cases we can ask for patient's LDH, bilirubin levels, etc. And how we will treat these patients after confirmation of the diagnosis? We will treat patients with either oral doses of folic acids with injectable forms of the vitamin B12. Thank you.